Well, it all started when Donald Trump became a serious threat to win the Republican presidential nomination. That was when the Never Trump movement effectively commenced, attracting an informal coalition of establishment war hawks and right-leaning intellectuals and party hacks, appalled at the prospect of a crude vulgarian like Donald Trump seizing control of their party. Now, you might have thought those people would come to their senses once the choice was narrowed to Trump and Hillary Clinton, but you would be wrong. The anti-Trump venom from this narrow sliver of the right has continued almost unabated through the first 18 months of his presidency. Never mind that Trump denied the left their dream of a fundamentally transformed America, saved the Supreme Court from leftist control, and vanquished the Clinton dynasty once and for all. Never mind that he's pushed through the first serious tax reform in more than a generation and ordered massive deregulation, two items always at the top of the conservative agenda. Never mind that this president may well be on track to stabilize the Korean Peninsula, or that he forced NATO allies to raise the ante in their own defense, or that he's pushing the envelope hard on getting trade deals more favorable to America. Never mind that the economy is roaring and jobs abounding. No, none of that matters because Trump's style is repulsive to the calcified Republicans and conservatives who have looked this gift horse straight in the mouth. And it makes one believe that what these Never Trumpers have really wanted all along is not what they have claimed, the power to effect consequential change in a nation heading for socialism. No, their behavior suggests that all they want is to protect their brand from this déclassé interloper, even if it means turning the White House and the country over to the left. So while Trump is busy fulfilling all the bold campaign promises he made that got him elected, the Never Trumpers stand on the sidelines and gripe and moan and carry on about how crude he is, the skunk at their garden party. Thus, it should not be surprising that the de facto leader of the Never Trump movement, the one-time editor-in-chief of the Weekly Standard, Bill Kristol, is reportedly well along in deciding to challenge President Trump for the 2020 presidential nomination of the GOP. Seriously. Now, rumors of his potential candidacy surfaced as early as March of this year when he attended a so-called must-show event for potential presidential contenders in New Hampshire. And going back a bit further, he provided the first hints of his candidacy when he told the New York Times in August of 2017 that, quote, "We need to take one shot at liberating the Republican Party from Trump and conservatism from Trumpism." Now, I'll provide just one soundbite of Mr. Kristol with his new best friends on MSNBC about how Trump is a stain on the presidency.
We've had a lot of demagogues, we've had a lot of liars, we've had a lot of irresponsible political leaders on both sides, honestly, over decades. We really haven't had one as president of the United States, and one who, as president, is using his standing, his office, to just make things, relentlessly to hammer away and make things worse.
Now, Kristol has not stopped at denouncing Trump every day and actively considering a run for president. In addition to regular appearances on MSNBC, where only anti-Trump Republicans are given airtime, he actually appeared this week on CNN, the home base for Never Trump Republicans, and offered advice for the Democrats on how to win the upcoming midterm election, saying they should play up the border separation issue. He said, quote, "Democrats, in my opinion, should keep the focus on these children, on the families. Our policy change the president ordered that was irresponsible and I think is, you know, wrong and then also incompetently executed. This is totally irresponsible and reckless governance by the president." So, of course, given that Kristol has become legendary around the D.C. swamp for his consistently wrong predictions and poor political judgment, we might only hope that the Democrats actually follow his advice. Now, You may recall that after Trump secured the GOP nomination in 2016, Crystal became a laughingstock when he promised to produce a serious challenger to Trump in the general election. But the only possible candidate who materialized was an obscure conservative writer named David French, who ultimately decided not to enter the race anyway. But now, Crystal has somehow convinced himself that Republicans will choose him over the 45th president. That may be even funnier than David French for president. Perhaps Mr. Crystal, who recently stated that Trump has brought out his own inner socialist, just thinks that simply by running for president, he'll be a hero to his fellow never-Trump travelers and, of course, the left. Certainly, he would receive all the political advice he needs from washed-up, radical, never-Trump GOP strategists like Anna Navarro and Steve Schmidt and Rick Wilson, whose acid-tongued denunciations of Trump on TV are just as unhinged as anyone on the left. But ultimately, folks, Mr. Crystal must be either delusional or masochistic or a primary victim of TDS, Trump Derangement Syndrome. Because when Trump is done with him, he will be shrunk into the size of a midget if he isn't already, same as low-energy Jeb Bush, little Marco Rubio, lying Ted Cruz, crooked Hillary Clinton, and the other career politicians who've been ridiculed, pulverized, and dismissed from the stage by the bombastic billionaire. Now, it may sound ludicrous that a president enjoying near 90% approval from the voters in his own party, higher even than Ronald Reagan, would be challenged in a primary. But then, sanity has never been one of the hallmarks of the Never Trump movement. Now, you need to know this, something that many people have forgotten, and that is that neoconservatives led by Mr. Crystal themselves seized control of the Republican Party from the traditional paleoconservatives at the turn of this century and severely degraded the GOP brand by convincing President George W. Bush to engage in the disastrous Iraq War. That gave us 8 years of Barack Obama. And now we're supposed to listen to these people when they effectively align themselves with the resistance by howling into the darkness about the horrors of Donald Trump as he fixes one long festering problem after another. But as the ad says, wait, that's not all. It seems others are considering a challenge to Trump for the GOP nomination, including Never Trump Senator Ben Sasse of Nebraska, acclaimed author Brad Thor, and yes, even the loser in the 2012 presidential election, Mitt Romney. Heck, why not run George Will out there as well? The once respected conservative scold would certainly receive favorable coverage from his new BFFs on MSNBC and the left. And come to think of it, why not Jennifer Rubin, the insufferable, quote, conservative columnist for the Washington Post, whose voice and entire countenance is akin to fingernails on the chalkboard. There's been much talk of the almost sociopathic rage against Trump on the left, but at least leftists have sound ideological reasons for opposing this president. Not so with never-Trump Republicans and conservatives, whose thirst to wall off their party from the deplorables has unmasked them as nothing more than control freaks and ingrates enamored of their own vanishing importance.